Hey, how's it going, y'all? So today's my birthday. It's March the 3rd. No, just kidding. It's March the 5th. So it's 5 plus 3 is 8. And then it's 2017, and then the 7 and the 1 is 8. So it's infinity times infinity. Now, I just discovered this a couple of days ago, and it was just like, whew. When I said those words, I could feel it in my cells. It was like my cells were rejoicing. Because it was the truth, and it was been the truth that I've been denying for a majority of my life. Flashback to third grade. So I got kicked out of one of my teacher's class for talking too much, and so I went to the hallway. I was sitting in the hallway, and as I was sitting in the hallway, there was another teacher, which happened to be a math teacher. She was making fun of a student, and she was making fun of their test scores. As the classmates were laughing, and that person happened to be me. So, like, I was just sitting there. It was like my inner lioness. I could feel it stirring within myself, and I was fixing to confront her, but I didn't. I just decided to just sit back instead. So, a couple years go by. I'm 12, and I'm fluctuating between weight, which is actually normal. Especially like, you're growing up and things like that. And I would have some people say, "Oh, okay, you've gained a little weight, or you've gained some weight, or you lost weight." And they would place my value on me losing weight. Say, "Oh my gosh, you look so pretty, like you lost weight." Or, "Oh, what's going on? Are you having too much bacon?" And make little jokes and stuff like that. And it was just like the feeling behind it. It would like make me sad for like days on out. Like, so then, I developed eating disorders and stuff like that. Well, not eating disorders, but an eating disorder. So, by the way, me telling this is not me being the victim or anything like that. I was just, it's kind of like the cause and effect, So I'm just looking back, and I mean, of course, everything is. You learn something, so you grow from it. So I'm in high school. I end up skipping a lot because I just get overwhelmed with numbers. I'm so afraid of numbers. And I think it stemmed from my teacher making fun of me, at least I thought, but maybe it had to do with dyslexia. I didn't find out I had dyslexia until much later because the only thing I would know is that I would flip numbers. When I would see 57, I would write 75 instead. So I don't know if it was because I was living a truth and everything else was backwards, or if I was backwards and everything else was living the truth. I'm not sure which one. So I, graduate from high school 2 years late, behind, feeling like a failure, measuring myself, against other people saying, "Oh, wow, look. They graduated on time. I didn't." And placing my value on that. So not only was I placing my value on my test scores, placing my value on my weight fluctuating up and down, but now I was, judging myself based on not graduating like with everybody else. So then I'm working. I'm in the workforce. And some of the jobs that I had have been really fast-paced. Me, I like to take my time. So then I remember this one job, just to kind of like wrap it up with a lot of the jobs that I've had. This one manager, he was like a micromanager, and he would just get so frustrated with me. Like, he was making like a salad, because I worked at like a sandwich place. And he was making what, salads like really quick. And he looked like he was like on something, like on speed or something like that. And it was just, he looked ridiculous. And then like I had a bathroom break, and then one of the assistant managers was knocking on the door, I freaking kid you not, and said, "Hi, are you almost finished in there?" And I'm like, "Is this real? Is this really happening?" So it was feeling, it just felt completely just like demeaning, kind of, just not the fact that I'm working at a sandwich place, but just the fact that they don't even like can't even respect if I'm like in the bathroom. Like, that was so freaking awkward. So later on in life, you know, I haven't ever got a license. I haven't drove because I have been afraid of being, like, in large, you know, like in traffic, because you have to be precise. And that's one of the things I'm afraid of, is precision. So one wrong turn, that's it, you're dead, you know? So I've been like a turtle. You know, I carry a heavy backpack, which sometimes feels like the debt that's on my shoulders of me trying to catch up, with everybody else, having certain things in life to make myself feel more important. It feels like that, you know, walking with a heavy backpack, trying to get to my destination, looking like a turtle, as traffic is going by quickly. So I guess because I felt like I have placed my value so much on numbers and measured myself, there was a time that I became kind of obsessed with numbers, because I felt like maybe I could find the meaning behind it. So if I would see triple fives, then I would say, okay, well, this means this. If I see triple fours, oh my gosh, well, this means this. And so then I would find meaning behind triple digits. But I probably chose triple digits because of the fact that there's no confusion in it. You can't really flip a five and a five and a five. I mean, if you do, it's okay, it's the same. So I guess my quest for the meaning of numbers finally hit me. Because, yes, I would notice triple digits of ones and threes and fours and fives and sevens. But then just one day, it was 2 days before my birthday, I never saw and I never understood the triple digits of eight. And then I realized it means infinity. And infinity is something that cannot be measured. It is boundless. It is like eternal. And so when I try to find meanings with all these triple digits, I finally came to the realization that the past, the present, and the future have only one meaning. And it's love. Because love cannot be measured. Love knows no bounds, and there's no limit on it. And that is like what I'm created from. That is who I am, and is my only truth. And because the world is different, and I'm living in this, you know, trying to compute in this world that is measured by those things, that's why I was wanting to take my time and not catch up with the lie that's told over and over and over. But this is my truth, and this is my freedom.